The bubonic plague. The plague is not a pleasant subject, but no discussion of medieval Europe is complete without covering this topic. The plague has visited mankind many times. It is mentioned in the Old Testament, and it was probably the disease that afflicted Athens during the Peloponnesian Wars. Europe was hit three times in the Middle Ages. The worst incident in the mid-1300s, where one quarter to one half of all Europe suffered an immensely unpleasant death. It was called bubonic, from the Latin word bubos, meaning swellings. Symptoms included swollen glands, fever, chills, headache, and extreme exhaustion. It was also called the Black Death because of the dark discolorations it caused. This dreaded disease was 90% fatal to humans. People tried to shield themselves from the plague by wearing protective clothing. Often they would wear bird-like masks with flower petals in the beak. Some, believing the god was punishing them, would whip themselves bloody as atonement. The Pope outlawed this practice and had offenders flogged. Many desperate people throughout Europe found a convenient scapegoat in the local Jews, and countless innocent Jews at this time were tortured and killed.
How many valiant men, how many fair ladies, breakfast with their kinfolk, and the same night supped with their ancestors in the next world. The condition of the people was pitiable to behold. They sickened by the thousands daily, and died unattended and without help. Many died in the open street, others dying in their houses, made it known by the stench of their rotting bodies. Consecrated churchyards did not suffice for the burial of the vast multitude of bodies, which were heaped by the hundreds in vast trenches, like goods in a ship's hold, and covered with a little earth. Giovanni Boccaccio.
Modern science has since discovered the cause of the plague. The black rat, genus species Rattus rattus, gets infected by the Yersinia pestis bacteria. A flea bites the infected rat, and the bacteria can live inside the flea's body. The flea then bites a human, regurgitating the bacteria into the human's body. Ironically, in the Middle Ages, people feared cats and often killed them. Cats could have saved innumerable human lives by killing sick rats. Nowadays, there are a few thousand cases each year occurring around the globe. Fortunately, this disease is easily treated with antibiotics. It's not uncommon for rodents to become infected. When outside enjoying nature, it's important to stay away from dead rodents and always report a dead rodent to a park ranger.